So I'm going to start off part two of this video to just show some stuff that doesn't work from the last video. So all these statue clips into the classrooms, some mechanic was changed, or sometimes you can't even sit on the statue. So these ones that are black and white, they just don't work anymore. But that's class two, class four, and class three, they all don't work. Clipping onto the roof from this thing doesn't work. You can still clip out of the greenhouse, but you don't get onto the roof with either. This one in the Hufflepuff dorm to go upstairs, not very useful, but I'd also just point out that this one does not work either. And then the one in the Great Hall that clips you onto the roof, this, it sometimes works, I've gotten it to work, but it's a lot more difficult than it was before. It's easier just to clip out through the windows and then spongify up onto the roof if you want to get on the roof of the Great Hall. So yeah, you'd clip out through the spawn area windows, like I showed in the previous video. So this first thing, I'm just showing you that you can, there's a third person menu that you can access, and that will show you invisible models and visible ones, of course. So I think the default bind is C. So you can actually move your mouse around, and whatever you move your mouse on, you can actually see the outline of. So here I'm just showing these ones that spawn. They've been here for a while. Before we didn't know you could see them, but now with this mechanic, you can see the invisible models and walk around. Also, a lot of the statues have these boxes around them. Not all of them. I think I'd say 5 or 6 of them do. And the interesting thing about these boxes is you can walk through them, so they have no collision, but you can still sit on them. So like that one, I looked down through it and sat on it. Another example of an invisible barrier is this one in front of the window, so people couldn't stand in the window and be annoying to class 3. This is just a cool bunny hop. You can bunny hop out of Spongify, and you maintain your speed, so if you really want to go fast, you can do that. There's more barriers here at Hagrid's house, so you can't go under his house. But the advantage to the one here is you can jump on top of it, which I'm standing on right now, and then you can jump into the window. I'll show that again. So you jump on the bottom one, and then you jump on there. You don't need Spongify. And if you hold control, it's important to stay crouching. And then when you stand up, you clip into Hagrid's house, which is useful for when his house is locked and you want to get in for whatever reason. And to get out, you can just sit on top of this dresser here, and that'll clip you out through the wall. In class 3, class 4, just like the previous clip I showed you before on the other side of the classroom, this picture frame can also clip you out of bounds. This puts you in the stairway. In the greenhouse, just like you can on the inside, we discovered you can sit on the outside. And you look kind of silly because you're behind these vines. In the bathroom stall, this is one of the ways to get into the moat clipping out of bounds. You can stand on this little lip of the stall here and go in the very back corner, walk all the way to the corner and crouch. Hold crouch and sit on this part of the stall. And you'll be halfway in the wall, and once you stand up, you will clip into the moat. This used to work on the other side, and clipping into the other bathroom, but they put barriers in the way, and it does not work anymore. Here's class 3. You can sit behind these stairs, and if someone stands on top of you, like right behind you, as you stand up, you can actually clip through the wall here, if you have an extra person to help you. Though it's not very useful, but it's just a good place to hide if you need that. Also in class 3, if you have Spongify, you can go up to the top window here and go into the corner. And if you sit right at the edge here, you don't need to pull up that menu, but if you sit right there and then stand up, you can clip out even through that barrier they have on the outside. In class 1, here's a very easy one without Spongify. If you just go into the corner and then move left while you mash Alt-E, you'll sit on the first position you can. This doesn't work on all the windows. Sometimes you have to try the left or the right side. But most of them, they work on this side of the roof. Here's just an example. It turns out that while you're being snatched, you have more control than the snatcher does, honestly. Like, you can just run away and not move. Or even better, you can sprint and jump and move even farther away. So when you're getting snatched, just know that you have more power. than you think you do. And I'll show here that you can hop very far away if given the opportunity while tied to something by just sprinting and jumping. For some reason I got quick jumps in there, I don't know what that was from. But yeah, if you just sprint and jump away, you don't have to bunny hop or anything. You just gotta keep staying in the air, you can move far away. And then get killed by Voldemort. So there's this new barrier by the dungeon, and they say staff only. But you can get through this. We found this first try. So either get on from either of these tables, you can jump on top of this thing or spongify. But get on the bottle wreck. And then you go all the way over the corner, hold control, see where you dip down there, and then sit on this part of the L-shaped column. And once you stand up, you'll go into that staircase area of the dungeon behind the barrier. From here, you can also see the invisible barriers in front of the prisons when you used to be down here, but you can still see them now. You can also, there's gaps in it, so you can throw dollars behind it. Haven't found a way to get people behind it, though. Thanks for watching.